so I've decided I want to try Age of Oblivion, but I want to try the new alpha. And there's been some confusion since my last video, and there's been some changes to it. So I want to go through again how to install Age of Oblivion onto your computer. Yeah, you know, kill all those spiders and bugs and you know what I mean, right? Let's go ahead and get into it here. There's three main parts to this: how to download it and where you can download it, to how to make profiles in Steam so that you can keep all of your modded games separate. Ooh. The fog's coming in. Great. Let's go ahead and get to it. So first thing to note is that as of recording today, Age of Oblivion is at 5.1 alpha, and it requires the alpha 20 version of 7 Days to Die. It will require what you see on my screen up there, alpha 20.3, beta 3, in order to work properly. And then once you have that, you will be able to use the latest version of Age of Oblivion. Now, to get the mod, you're going to go to the forums, the regular 7 Days to Die forums. This is where all of the updates to Age of Oblivion get posted and where the updated link can be found, unless you go to the Discord. There's a link to the Discord there. And you can find me in the Discord as well, if you really want to find me there as well. Yes, I have 2 Discord accounts, so don't be surprised. Go to Google. If you don't know where the forums are, go to Google. Type 7 Days to Die forums. Really easy. Type it out. And then it'll come up and it'll spit out, hey, you want to go to these places? And you just click on mods. You want to go into the mods subfolder. Now, once you go into mods, at the very top, you'll find a search box. See it right there? There's a search box right there. Now, go to that search box and type in Age of Oblivion. And then you don't have to worry about trying to find and scroll and, you know, where you want to go and, you know, where did it go this time? Just type it in, search it, hit enter. Once you hit enter, it'll be the first option right at the top. Underneath that pinned thread right there. Click on that thread. You'll see a whole bunch of stuff in there. There's description, and you know, you probably read it by now. Scroll on down until you see Alpha 5.1 download. It got really dark, foggy and dark. Okay, the name will change, but it will always say Age of Oblivion, but you may find that it'll say different things as updates come out, because it is still being worked on quite extensively, I might add. Right next to it, you'll also find the link to the Discord if you want to. Quite helpful there. Now, once you have gone to the download link, you will end up on a visualstudio.com. So you're going to go over here, over to the right, and you'll see 3 dots. Click on that 3 dots and click on download as a zip. And that will download the mod zip file. Now, this zip file is really, really large. If you have a really slow internet, I recommend you set this to download just before bed and go to bed. Can't really see me. Let me get a little closer here. Sorry about that. With the night and everything, had to get inside and turn the lights on so that you could see me. Before you ask, no, there is no mirror. There's only 1 download link. While it is downloading, go ahead and create your Steam profile. Now, to create a Steam profile, this is going to essentially copy your game. This is what all mod launchers do to create profiles. They make a copy of the game to keep the game from being corrupted, the original game. This is why you need to have an updated game file, because it will use the updated game. Open Steam, right-click on your 7 Days to Die game. Preferably, that's your vanilla game. You haven't installed any mods into it. So right-click on 7 Days to Die, go down to Manage, and then click on Browse Files. This will take you to your game files for your main vanilla game. You will see the 7 Days to Die EXE, the 7 Days to Die EAC EXE. That's where you need to be. If you see a mods folder, go into that. Make sure that it is empty so that you have a full vanilla file. Assuming that you have verified files, you have a good game setup. All right, let's go. go up here to the arrow, the up arrow here. This will take you up one folder. Go ahead, click on it. Have the 7 Days to Die folder there. Good. Now you're going to right click on it and go down and select copy. Go down into a blank space below that. You're going to left click once to deselect your 7 Days to Die folder, then right click and click on paste. Once you do that, it'll make a copy of your 7 Days to Die folder, the entire game, right there. It'll come up and it will make a 7 Days to Die dash copy folder, which is what you want. Once it is done copying, go ahead and right click on it and choose rename. Take out that copy and that dash and put in AOO for Age of Oblivion. Or if you're installing something else, go ahead and change it to whatever you want, whatever is recognizable to you. Once you've done that, hit enter. Good. Now we have our Age of Oblivion profile we can install in. Yay! Let's go back to the download. It's over here in my downloads, and I use 7-Zip to open all of my zip files. It is free. The download link will be in the description. You can go and get it, but you can also use the zip program built into Windows if you want. You can use WinZip, whatever you're comfortable with. I like 7-Zip because I can do what I'm going to show you here. So in the downloads, right click on the zip file, go to 7-Zip and do open archive. This will allow you to see what's in the zip file through 7-Zip. And I'll just move the folder off over here to the side so that we can see both folders side by side like that. Okay. Now that we have both folders side by side, we're going to go ahead and move everything over. You'll notice that there's only a mods folder in the zip file. This is on purpose. As of Alpha 5, there is no data folder. Don't need it anymore. So yes, this is the big update from my last video. You do not have a data folder. It's gone. Poof, gone. Okay, so take that mods folder, highlight it, and drag it over to the other window. Make sure, though, you do not have any folder highlighted when you go to drag it over, because you do not want to drop it into any folder. So put it into a blank white space over there and then let go. Even if you do not have a mods folder there, it will create it for you. Now let it copy. It's going to take a while. It's 4.5 gigs to copy over. It will be nothing like the download. It'll just take a while to copy over. And once it's done, you're good. Almost. So now, let's go back to Steam. Back to Steam. So back in Steam, go to Game. Up at the very, very top up there, click on Game. Now you're going to go down to Add Non-Steam Game. Yes, I know this is a Steam game, but trust me. Go to Add Non-Steam Game, then ignore everything that comes up and click on Browse. Once you click on Browse, you're going to want to go to that AOO folder that we just created. I don't know where Steam is going to place you. If it does not bring you to that folder or does not bring you close to that folder, you are going to have to go find it. Once you go find it and you're in that folder, and you see that 7daystodie.exe and 7daystodieeac.exe, you're in the right place. Just make sure you're in your AOO folder. Age of Oblivion requires EAC off. This means that you need to choose the one without EAC. So click on the 7daystodie.exe and then click on open. Okay. Whichever it says down there. Once you've done that, then go ahead and click OK in Steam. And you'll see that it says 7 Days to Die, and it's all one word. Go ahead and right-click on it, go down, click on Properties, and then you can change the name. And I'll change it to 7 Days to Die AOO. So now, in Steam... Oh, good, it's morning. So in Steam, I can now easily see, hey, I have 7 Days to Die, which is vanilla. That's what we're in now, and we have 7 Days to Die AOO for Age of Oblivion. So now you can just click on play and go straight into Age of Oblivion and not have to worry. You can go play with the bugs. You can go play with all of those weird creatures and all the great stuff in Age of Oblivion, like the extra food and the extra weapons and all of the extra stuff in the mod. So if you have enjoyed the video and it has been very helpful to you, I would appreciate it if you scratch that like button for me. And as always, I'll see you in game.